Hey, who are you to tell me what's right and wrong? Don't judge me.
Are you kidding me? Y'all Christians are so judgmental. Do you not realize that sin is sin?
Of course we're trying to fill these seats. After all, church is for everybody.
Now, I'm pretty sure you've heard those phrases before. Chances are you probably used them yourself. You know, they have been coined as Christian language during these times, but my question to you is, how Christian is our Christian language? You know, when we say partial things that are in Scripture, do we mean what the Bible means when we say them? Oh, I have something for you.
We as Christian leaders need to stay coachable, to stay teachable, to stay continually ready to hear what the Spirit's speaking. And I think the New Age Vernacular speaks a very pertinent message to the leaders in the 21st century. That message that we have to be careful of letting the world's lies infiltrate the body of Christ.
Like, it will change your life and it will change your thinking. Even as I was reading and turning the pages, I knew that my mind was changing.
I'm excited about the release of the New Age Vernacular. I don't think there's another voice in the kingdom that's probably more suited to speak on the subject. And so I'm excited he's attacking some of the common phrases that we've been hearing in the church lately. Some of these kind of things that we hear nowadays that sound good, but just don't really line up with the Word of God.
I've heard nearly all of those, some of them more than others, and some of them are extremely prevalent. And I think he does a great job of pointing out the error in some of the things that we say and accept in our everyday Christian language.
Recognizing these untruths will help you better understand and better navigate your world.
The book is informative, it's insightful, and it's helpful. It's just like he's actually sitting there having a one-on-one conversation with you, and you can't help but to keep turning the pages.
Apostle Andrew Crawley is a kingdom voice. He's a man of God who loves God, who loves his family, who loves the church, and wants to see God's people not lose sight or focus on what the main thing is.
I think Andrew's heart is to help people come to a grasping of, number one, I'm being deceived, and number two, there's a better way, and it's through God's Word.
Now hear me, if you are a Christian with breath in your body today, you've got to get this information in your hand. The reason why you need a New Age Vernacular is because Satan has always delighted in attempting to merge the mindset of the sacred and the profane. And he knows before he can merge mindsets, he must first merge their language. Because hey, if he can get us saying the same thing, he can ultimately get us to embrace and then do the same things.
And to be able to quickly go through and say, wow, you know, I haven't spoken to that to my people, and they really need to hear that this is not the Word of God that's been taught.
Well, it's something that the church as a whole really needs to hear.
The church folk, Christian believers, they should get their hands on this book. The Bible says, with all thy getting, get understanding. And that's what you get when you read the New Age Vernacular, is you get understanding of the New Age Vernacular. It's truth. It's truth in that book. And if you love God and you want to go after truth, this is a good book for you to read. It's an excellent book.
And we need to be able to lovingly respond to that. And the New Age Vernacular helps us do that.
If you've not gotten a copy, get a copy. If you got a copy, buy another one and bless somebody with it, so that this word can spread and we can just be made better in the kingdom of God.
My friends, get the New Age Vernacular today. I don't know if it'll make things easier, but it will make you more compatible with the mindset of the Scriptures and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.